Did you know that when you file for Chapter 7 and get a discharge, that you discharge your mortgage too? Isn't that great? Not actually how it works. Unfortunately, when you file for Chapter 7, you do discharge your personal liability, but not the mortgage. Hi, I'm Scott Goldstein. I'm the owner of the law offices of Scott J. Goldstein. And today I want to talk to you about a unpleasant and annoying part of bankruptcy, which is reaffirmation of a debt. Now, reaffirmation is something that is well-known in the bankruptcy community, but it's confusing to our clients. And I think that it would be helpful to understand a little bit about how it works. So in the good old days before the 2005 amendments, you used to be able to do what we call ride through on a loan, which meant that you could just keep making your payment on things like cars and mortgages, and the lender couldn't repossess the vehicle, couldn't do anything to you, and you could just move along with your life without worrying about being responsible for that debt if something went wrong. In 2005, the law was changed and a reaffirmation requirement was put into place for personal debts. And what we mean by personal debts is cars, things of that nature. So personality that you have a payment plan on. So if you wanted to keep your car, if you wanted to keep maybe some furniture that you had a payment plan on, you would be required to reaffirm that debt in order to keep that property. That does not apply, however, to real property. So my clients will generally be required to reaffirm the debt on their car. That means you're going to pull it back out of the bankruptcy and be responsible for the payments if you want to keep that vehicle. And that is annoying to many clients that they have to go through an additional hearing. It is a problem for them if they have to show that they can afford the payments and it's not an undue hardship, but you get through it and move it. What you have a problem though is real property. It is considered almost malpractice among consumer bankruptcy attorneys to reaffirm on a residential mortgage. And the reason we say this is that there is no need to do so. The code does not require it. And frankly, it creates more problems for clients to actually reaffirm than to not. Where the question now comes into play is, what happens if you want to refi? Some mortgage lenders will tell you, well, you need to reaffirm the mortgage. If your case has been discharged, you can't do that. What you need to do is keep a good solid record of all of your payments and show it to your lender so they can see that you made your payments, or take it to a new lender. Just because you have your existing loan with Wells Fargo doesn't mean they have to do your refi. If you have any questions about this, please reach out to me. I'm happy to discuss this sort of thing with anybody. My name is Scott Goldstein, Law Offices of Scott J. Goldstein. Hope we can help you.